That's the song that was playing at the gym.
Yeah. This gets me amped. Anyway, where were we?
Playing at the gym.
Oh.
So you're going to be ripped for your wedding?
I don't know. We'll see. But I'm starting to understand, what is it? What's it called when you pay someone to beat you up?
Personal trainer.
Dominatrix.
Yeah, I'm starting to understand that. I'm like, hey, I'll pay you twice a week to beat me up, and I'll go do it myself.
Fight Club. It's nice. It's really nice.
Yeah. Oopsie.
I hope you tell Amanda that. Hey, I'm gonna hire one of them dominatrixes for our wedding.
It's fine. It's a trainer. No, but if you like, seriously, if you think about it, like I just paid a much larger man
to, to take advantage of you.
Yeah, like he was $25.
Like, how often do you have to pay that $25?
I got a deal on these sessions. These ones were only like 10 apiece.
All right, that doesn't answer my question though.
Do you have to pay for a gym membership on top of that?
Yeah.
Oof.
I own too many polluted deltas.
What's that?
Nonsense.
I own 9.
Own 9?
That's a lot of polluted deltas.
Right, well, I'm going to continue watching the Berenstain Bears on their own, and you on your own.
Until Juan gets here?
Yeah. Well, yep. I should probably start up the program, though.
Yeah,
I'm
going
to continue watching the Berenstain Bears on their own, and you on your own.
What? Until
somebody Juan just rolled here. 3 dice.
It was a smite.
Wow. Oh, did you just smite Aleister Black, the necromancer?
Maybe.
Nice.
No, that's not good for you, Dave.
Hold on.
Hello.
Sexy pizza.
Hey, Domino's has pizzas 50% off right now.
Hold on.
Hello.
Sexy all right. Pizza.
Hey, Domino's has pizzas 50% off right now.
Alright, so how's this new headset sounding?
Pretty clear.
I was wondering if it was my headset right. Or your headset or something that was sounding
hey,
different.
Domino's has pizzas 50% off right now.
I got a new headset. A little quiet though.
Alright, so how's this new headset sounding? Okay, I'm gonna turn that up.
Yeah.
Oh.
And how do I sound?
Handsome.
Oh. You know, this was in the 80s. Casey was still going strong in the 80s.
What was?
Casey and the Sunshine.
Ah. Yeah.
There were a lot of bands still going strong in the 80s.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
I'm trying to get my push to talk to work.
That's true.
I'm trying to get my push to talk to work.
So I just put on Earth, Wind, and Fire September, and I am woefully underdressed to watch this video. Also, I am not on enough drugs.
Yeah. Except for Grizzly Bits or Sparkles.
Do I own a poll from tomorrow? I feel like I
do. When are we just going to just start doing drugs?
You know, I feel like we had this conversation like 10 years ago. The problem was we were poor.
Yeah.
Do I own a poll from tomorrow? I feel like I do.
When are we just going to just start doing drugs?
And now we've got, I've gotten to the point where I have money.
But I have you're no spending sources. It on magic cards.
Well, I'm done with that for now.
I'm just going to really get into, like, cocaine.
Well, see, I actually got a... I should send this on Discord. Let me see if I need to look for a card real quick.
I think if I start doing meth, I won't ruin Dave's pictures. I'll probably be dead, but...
Well, you just don't smile.
Don't do meth just for the pictures. Do it because we want you to live.
Probably be dead.
Do meth because you'll
want to. Well, you
just
don't smile. Can we just have like a giant like underground meth party at your wedding, Dave?
Oh no, no, actually, that'd be terrible because there'll be a lot of law enforcement there.
Do meth because you'll want to.
Well, you just don't smile.
I'll be the hookup.
Can we just have like a giant like?
I'm sure they know a guy.
Yeah.
All right, general.
They're all from Michigan, right?
Minnesota.
So they know, like, plenty of people.
And they don't have jurisdiction.
No, no, they do, because it will be my father-in-law's, like, area. All
right. So check out the general chat. This was listed to me on my Facebook.
All right, you know what? I just say we stay fucking and start doing crocodile.
Just give ourselves a year, and then that'll be good.
Yeah.
Wish was selling cocaine for $4.
No.
See, I can get in on that.
Right?
Yeah, my wish was...
I don't know what this Wish program is, or site, or whatever.
It's a buy anything site.
Including cocaine?
Like I've heard advertisements on the radio.
Wow.
So I could actually get cocaine from that.
Yeah,
website.
I had one time it advertised to me thumb screws, and then I went and deleted my browsing history because I was like, this is pretty bad.
Thumb
Yeah.
Okay. I'll play the uneducated person. What the fuck are thumb screws?
They're little vices that they put on your fingers to torture you.
Oh.
Yeah, it's not a good thing.
No, no, it isn't.
Okay, so it was exactly what I thought.
Yes.
Huh. What the fuck are you looking at?
I don't know.
Well, apparently I'm looking at cocaine.
Let's see if there's...
I mean, I was watching Narcos, but...
I wonder if I'll get
one. Oh, here you go. Man breaks fingers as he tests out torture device.
Well, there's a reason.
The product works.
What did we learn? The product works.
Oh, this guy looks like...
What the fuck?
I'm a little nervous to watch this.
Media drum world. All right. I think this guy's a little out of his element.
Where's this video?
I posted it on Facebook.
Just...
Oh, okay.
Oh, man, I can't handle this.
Yep, me. Wow. 13 seconds in, I'm already terrified. And then the
thumbs are grabbed. He hasn't done anything yet. He's just explaining the device. Close
up with this. Okay, but look at the scenery. What is behind here? There's a
dog mask one?
That's a good one.
The one to the left of that one is just creepy.
See what sort of damage is happening here.
Oh, we'll see the one in the case. It's a holy relic.
That's just brutal.
Probably to exercise the devil or something.
We'll squeeze the devil out of your feet.
That looks like one of those like awful pears or something.
This seems.
Oh, that ending. What are you doing?
I don't know if I can. Oh god, no.
No. No. Just no.
Nope. Done. This is not okay. Never mind. I take back everything I said about gym trainers. I'm not into that.
Oh, it's not
that's
not too bad.
Oh yeah, it's starting to press.
Holy shit! The credits roll right after the snap. What?
Dude, that was two.
He goes, cut!
So fake, cool device, though. Haha, get it? Device, haha. That did sound weird. I don't think bones breaking sound like that.
Well, have you ever broken them like that?
No, but...
Here's a little something to spice up the... bring us back, if you will.
Did I hear a Vaughn, by the way?
Yeah, he's here.
I've been here.
Oh. Okay. You didn't announce yourself with your usual flourish.
I have arrived.
Hey, Vaughn's here.
All right, sweet. Vaughn's here.
Can you, Cooper, are you watching this music video I sent?
Hold on. I went to YouTube Haiku. Right here. Hopefully the thumbnail doesn't ruin it. Let's see. Okay, it does. I'll just delete the thumbnail. It's nothing bad. Oh.
Dave, how do I get a more toned ass without working anything else?
Work your legs and your glutes.
Squats. Squats and oats.
Squats and oats. Yeah, steak and eggs also.
Is this an exercise video or a band?
This is Casey and the Sunshine. And I need you to recognize the prowess of his pants.
Does he have a permit for that animal?
I don't know. So Casey or the snake guy?
He's got a creepy stare. I don't like it. The stare is way too intense.
But, okay, look. He's wearing teal pants and a shirt that says, "I'm going to a fish fry Friday night." How do you not fall in love with it?
His stare.
Guys, I'm pleased to have been $1 Long Island the entire month of December.
Are you finally breaking your shit? Are you finally breaking one?
For a dollar?
No.
Has your juiciness finally went out?
You can't turn down a dollar.
Well, it's not just a dollar. You got to think of how much money you're saving.
Didn't buy it, you'd be saving even more.
That doesn't
make a lick of sense. I'm sorry. I'm the worst.
Dave doesn't even drink.
What do we think of Thanos?
Looks like Homer Simpson.
You look like Homer Simpson.
Fair. That's harsh, but fair.
Wait, Dave. Yeah. You plan to be here later in the month?
Yeah. Actually, I was going to ask about that. Because I'm going to try to get there on, like, the 20th or 21st.
Sure.
You don't mind me sticking one or two nights there? Just on a couch or something?
Just sleep in Kurt's bed.
Is Kurt going to be there?
I don't know. Oh, my God. I don't know if you guys would update about the Kurt situation.
No.
Since he said that he's not renewing.
Okay, so me and C, like, I've been really anxious about telling Kurt that, like, we're not going to sign with him. Like, if he tries to sign, we're not going to sign with him. So Steve talked to him and was like, Steve asked him what his plan was, and it turns out that he wasn't going to sign anyway, so we didn't have to be mean to him. So now Mark will be our roommate.
I am
Kowski.
Mark Wachowski, yep.
Dude, I am really? I am fascinated by that addition to the group.
It's gonna be so quiet in the house. Dude's gonna be. I want to see. He's got. Man, I bet he's gonna have like epic story. Like you're just gonna be like, yeah, dude. I woke up and he was like taped the wall or something.
No, it's gonna be that weird stuff like how his refrigerator stopped working.
He just brings that with him.
Broken fridge.
Well, because the thing is, like me, Steve, and Mark are all introverts, so like, it's gonna be a very quiet household.
There's gonna and be all... ponies everywhere.
It's also gonna be. It could also be very passive aggressive because nobody's confrontation.
Should I just? You know? I hope there's a giant "Don't Tread on Me" flag put up somewhere.
I had one for a while until I realized what it actually was, so I could do mine.
Cooper's like, I like my truck, and I like "Don't Tread on Me."
And now I was like, maybe I hate the bricks don't. Too. Ever since then, I was like, maybe I'm just get rid of this.
It's like, what's the password? What do you feel about taxation?
Yeah, Mark's gonna set up a little gate to get into the house. Well, this is my privatized sidewalk.
I ain't paying rent. That's like a form of taxation.
I'll charge all the guests who come in here.
Oh my god, that post you made, Chris. Why do you gotta just throw hornet nests in the room and then leave?
Listen, I just wanted to... I just asked a question, and then it just turned into a...
It's like, my name's Chris Preston, yeah. Here's these beats. What do you think about it?
Hey, what do you guys feel about my timeline? It's a fucking intellectual jousting area for some reason.
Hold on.
But no one's intellectual.
Christopher James Preston. All right, let's see here.
I'm surprised Mark hasn't jumped in there. I think Stone deleted his comment tagging him.
Which posts are we looking for?
I like that Michael Brown didn't actually answer.
Is it the Robert Reich's post?
No, it was the poll I made about how do you feel about taxation, and then Chris.
Also, that picture just confused me, Chris.
Listen, he's a multi-limbed rich man, okay?
But what about the other guy? Why would he have two wallets?
It's a metaphor for two wallet man.
Chris, was that the first time you've seen Thursday afternoon?
See, the reason for the two wallets...
What's Thursday afternoon?
The black kid?
Yeah, that's the first time I've ever seen that in my life.
I watched that video... every Thursday. Double cheeked up.
I have never seen that in my life, and it changed my life.
Yeah, they put that Turdo page posted every Thursday afternoon.
Oh, are we streaming?
Oh, yeah. We've been streaming for a while.
Oh.
Damn.
I see.
Well, the liberals.
damn Trump.
You're furry.
The furry should be excluded.
Anybody who doesn't believe in Trump can get out of the D&D stream.
I like furry white nationalists.
I can't. No, I can't.
Dave, listen.
Does it hit too close to home, Dave? Is that why you can't?
No, I'm just no. What is it,
Dave? What else are you paying people for?
Don't worry about it.
You yiffing?
Oh, is that whole story about him hiring that dominatrix on stream?
Yeah, actually it is. I was trying to get my push to talk to work, that's why I was doing it, so like it's gonna be all goofy and fucked up. Why did Josh Schumann, are you in the chat? Why did you just comment on the wrong post? You were like, this is the best D&D stream, the last one from last week.
Hold on, there's a Digimon marathon going on in the Twitch?
Oh, we're losing Cooper.
We're losing viewers fast.
Don't advertise other streams.
Who's watching this dingo of a situation?
I don't know. Are you guys ready to start yet?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, that didn't sound real enthusiastic.
Yeah!
There we go.
Yowza.
Why am I not subscribed?
Yeah, why doesn't Paul Ryan have a fourth arm?
You know, it's a weird story.
I got some theories behind that. He gave up his fourth arm in order to get into the GOP.
Okay.
Down the street also, one day, and you know, I'll be looking at asses and shit, and I see little yoga pants coming out the nail salon. So I look, like I peep the ass out, and I'm like, damn, she's thick as fuck. Turn around, TT. I'm like, damn, nigga, what you doing out here with all this ass?
Monopoly guy.
Double cheeked up on a Thursday afternoon. Hella ass. The sun is still out, my nigga. It was just, I don't know. All
right. So who wants to recap last session?
That's the home.
It's been too long.
Well, we were hired by the sheriff of Bogton to go investigate what's been going on with these weird scaly murder type things. It's been raining for what, like a month straight? We sit out trying to find tracks and end up coming across some cages that are over by a river, one of which held a necromancer. And the other one had a strange frog creature. There were some lizard men who threw javelins at us.
One very big one that was very angry.
Well, no, there's also a guard drake and a kobold in another cage. We slew the guard drake, even though it tore us up. And we released the necromancer, and I think that's about where we were. The lizard men did some sort of fog trick and disappeared. And we're here.
All right.
Did I live? I lived, right?
Yes, you lived.
But at what cost?
Let's see.
We met a guy who looked like David Bowie in a cage.
Well, you haven't really met him yet. You haven't talked to him yet. You just killed the Drake.
Yeah, we need to discuss with David Bowie.
He's from Bronx.
Huh. All right, so talk to him.
Are you safe? Did they hurt you? Why did they imprison you?
You talking to me?
talking to me?
Well, yes.
Cool. Oh, all right. Well, then yes. I do believe I'm safe.
Am I safe?
What is safe, really?
Yeah, are any of us safe?
No. I was drinking at a bar 2 nights ago. I only had like 3 tankards, so normally that's a pretty calm night for me. And next thing I know, I wake up and I'm in a cage. And they're poking me with sticks. And that happened for about a day. And here we are.
Bada boom, bada bing. Hmm.
Looking around, go ahead.
Oh, so 3 tankers is what's your normal drinking amount?
7 to 8.
7 to 8. So you think they might have been tampered with?
Could be. I don't know. I'm really into orbs, so I was really more focused on it. So it's very possible somebody slipped me a Mickey.
Were you in the town of Bogton?
I'm sorry, say that again.
Do lizard men slip you Mickeys often?
I don't think so. This is the first time I've ever woken up in a strange place.
Hmm.
Were you in the town of Bogton?
I don't know.
Oh, a different town, possibly.
Geography is not one of my strong suits. Like I said, I'm more of an orb guy.
Got this orb.
Do you collect orbs? Do you look at orbs?
Use them.
Juggle.
He is David Bowie.
Oh my god, he is.
I got this Fushigi.
Well, where were you heading? Or you were staying at a bar or whatnot, but did you have pressing business?
I mean, I don't really like my type in town that much because I can do magics with my orbs.
Dave, actually, what type are you? Out of game.
On the night that you passed out, were you doing any magic?
I'm a wizard.
Damn it! I thought he would be a fighter.
Specifically, a wizard too.
Electric boogaloo.
What kind of skin you got?
Well, I'm a people.
Okay, that's all I wanted to know.
Yeah, yeah. If you want to know my name, it's Alistair.
Okay. Alistair, so you're kind of like Rick from Rick and Morty, right?
I don't know what that is, but maybe. So to answer your question, yes,
Dave's been away from us too long. The internet's flowing away from him.
No, I know what Rick and Morty is, but my God, there's so much TV.
Rich and Mitchy.
Yeah. No, to answer your question, I was doing a couple small magic tricks to win some free booze, but nothing major. I didn't raise the dead or anything.
Dead? Many people tend to be nervous of anyone who practices magic, for good or ill.
I was like pulling shekels from behind ears.
Still what? Suspicious.
Sorcery.
And guess the card and that kind of thing.
Hmm.
So, I don't know.
Depending on your audience, they might still burn you at the stake.
I can say, tough crowd. They weren't a real big fan of me, but they didn't run me out or, you know, tar and feather me or anything. So,
but I'm in this cage.
Yeah, but then I got in this cage and they poked me. Mercilessly, just poke.
Oof.
Did you notice anything weird about your captors? Did they have any marking or symbol on them? Or did they speak about you in a language you could understand?
Well, they were lizards, so that was an alarm.
They were hissing at me?
Yeah, I don't know, they spoke in lizard, I think. I didn't really pay attention. I was too busy getting poked and prodded with sharp sticks.
Chris, while these guys are talking, I'm going to kind of go check out the other two huts.
Okay. So, you go into the first one. Which one are you going into?
The
map should still be up.
The second one.
I don't see the map. Do I have to hit something to see the map?
There we go.
I want to check out this one.
All right.
I got nowhere to be. You mind if I join you, fellas?
I've got no problem with it.
I'm really hurt, like right.
Safety in numbers. So, what about our two other captors here?
Oh, I don't know about them. Maybe they were the same situation. I never talked to them. One was just like hissing at me. The one over here.
Hmm. Was he doing anything now?
Well, I just poked him, so he kind of snapped at me. So, that doesn't like to be touched, is what I'm gathering. Yeah.
Oh, okay, so nobody speaks Draconic. Good to know.
Oh, no.
Hold on.
Hold up, we them boys.
I'd like to re-roll my languages, please.
Double-cheeked up on a Thursday afternoon.
Nope.
Doesn't look like it. So, what do you guys do? What brought you out here to the cages?
Well, we had been various travelers in the town of Bogton and got into a bit of a scuffle there. Things were cleared up a bit by the sheriff, and the next morning at the bar that we had been drinking at, we found someone dead and heard about weird murders. Things have been odd there, and we decided to help out by trying to figure out what's going on. We followed some tracks this way.
Ah. So just to clear up any questions, no, I did not.
I have a lot of... really hurt.
Hi, Alistair.
Well, based on his timeline story, it checks out.
Yeah, well, plus, I mean, you guys found a glove, right?
A glove?
Yeah, I mean, if it doesn't fit, you must quit.
We didn't find any orbs, that's for sure.
I know, because they stole them. They loved them. They were so great. They're so round. I'm just drilling the orbs.
What about that frog guy who was trying to snap at us through the cage? Is he doing anything?
The kobold was screaming after Alistair started poking him in a language that none of you seem to understand. The Bullywug's kind of backing away from his from you guys in the cave, our cage, like in fear now that you guys are killed the guard Drake.
Is there anything on the guard Drake? Did it have like a collar or anything, or?
No collar, like no chains, nothing. It just seems like it was
big angry lizard.
Yep.
Looks
like Chris understood that, huh? All right, let's switch over to Chris in the hut.
Yep.
So you go into the smaller of the two huts, and it kind of is the floor like goes down, and it's a room dug into the hill that you're on.
Like a staircase going down, kind of thing, or like a ramp going down.
Like a small ramp. It's like a it's just one big room that's dug in, so it's not level.
Isn't it raining here?
No.
Okay. So that seems highly dangerous.
It's not dug in a lot, like 3 feet or so. But on each side of the room, you see like about a dozen or so beds, like lined up the wall, like kind of like bunk beds.
So the middle is kind of dug in, and there's beds on the edges.
Yeah.
So it's more of like, it's not just like a scouting camp. It's like a lot of people camping out here.
Well, it's like a trench. It's like their trenches, kind of.
Well, it's their barracks.
I don't know.
I'm going to kind of...
Well, I mean, if you have 12 bunk beds.
I'm going to kind of snoop around the bed, see what I can find anything.
All right.
Can I go and check out the other one while he's doing that?
Well, this is why you guys were all talking with...
Oh, yeah, okay.
So. All right, make a investigation roll.
Hey. Whoops, that was the wrong button. Whoop, hold on.
No, you rolled an investigation.
Oh, my thing was blocking it. Okay.
Okay. One of the higher up beds, you actually do find a small doll of, and it looks like it would be a lizard person doll.
Like a kid doll, kind of stitched together sort of thing?
Yeah.
All right. I'll kind of scoot that in like a bag and I guess leave. Is there anything in the trench? Like, can I like go down by the trench, kind of touch the wall, see if there's something in there?
It more so is like a trench to make the room bigger.
Like a sunken living room?
Yeah.
Okay.
So there's not really anything in there, as it's also the main walking area.
All right.
Dave's getting all worried.
No, not at all. I just thought.
Don't worry, man. You're safe on the internet with me. I got you in good hands.
I'm about to make this video worthless. Dave Roberts in 2009 was accused of...
Oh, God.
Being handsome.
Anyway,
too handsome. And reliable.
They dropped that.
And trapped that thing. Thank you.
He was found not handsome in court of law.
By a jury of his peers.
Oh. Well, if you're in a jury of your peers, you can't be handsome. Because they're all handsome. Exactly.
He was playing the most beautiful game.
Hey, question.
All right.
Is it, you know how like my orbs were stashed in a little stashy spot near my cage?
Yeah.
Are there any more of those like near these other two?
No.
No, just like more like stashy spots where the people in the cages were, you know, like I'm sure they've got their equipment from them.
Well, in the same stashy spot that you had, there's a couple jars.
Ooh. Like anything in them?
Clay jars. Are you opening it up?
Yeah, I'm going to go over and open her up.
Snake. All right, out comes a flurry of bees. There's a couple of jars.
That's not how you store honey.
All right, give me a second. How do I attack bees?
By running away.
I think, well, actually, if I hit them with, like, a sword, like, that still works the same, right, because they're not individual bees.
They are individual bees.
No, I know, but I mean in terms of fighting.
One, they don't form up into one giant Voltron super bee.
let's not get into combat here. Roll for initiative, and there's 40 bees we have to roll for.
Can I shock and grasp bees?
You can shock and grasp a bee.
Then I'm gone.
When you open it up, the jar, the kobold starts yelling at you again.
Oh, then I'm going to light up a cigar and go back. Bees hate cigars, at least I think. That's
he
it.
Says the exact same sentence that you heard before. Yeah, that's what you make out of it.
Quick side question here. For the language thing, if we understand that language, does it come up in proper, like,
yep.
So that we can read it? Okay.
Like in Warcraft.
All right. Give me a language you can speak.
Casey. Hold on.
I believe it's under your abilities tab on your character.
Okay. No, that's not what I want.
Well, I just have two of my choice. Oh, I can still change that. Interesting.
Abilities.
All right. Here we go.
I can speak Gnomish and Common. Cool. Okay. Hey guys, he said that.
Oh.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And hello to you. Oh, actually it wasn't to me, never mind.
What's a Cooper?
Doesn't have all of them though. What?
What's a Cooper?
It's a barrel maker.
It is.
I thought you were a rapper.
And I rapper. My family's heritage was a barrel maker.
Oh.
A long line of barrel makers.
We make all kinds of barrels. Big barrels, small barrels, medium-sized barrels, barrels with little holes in them.
And they get mad at me for magic? Holes in
them. Huh?
Root beer barrel.
No orb sized barrels.
I'm gonna scoot over and start checking out the other the bigger one.
Alright.
Can I pick up that jar that he was squawking about?
The one with all the bees in it?
Yeah. I lit a cigar, it's cool.
The smoke chased them off.
Yeah, they hate
for wanting all the two
cigars.
Yeah, so I'm joining Chris in exploring this other one.
All right, what are you doing, Arthur?
Oh, yeah.
He's probably out making something. All right, what are you doing, Bromos?
Well, they're covered over on that side, at least with a pair of people. How tall are these banks? Like further down this river bit? Like, cool. Is this actual stream?
Yeah.
One second.
Climbing up the hills is probably about like 5 or 6 feet.
Okay. I was gonna head over near the cages then.
All right.
One second. Yep. Eventually, I want to get down. See you over.
You cut out there. See you over where?
Oh, like here, so I can kind of see both over to where the huts are and everyone else, basically, just in case something happens.
All right. Vaughn, are you back?
I guess I'll. How wounded am I? Is that my sheet?
There's a party sheet thing that shows everyone's.
You have 8 hit points taken of. I think you have 14 max, but you have the -2 because of your blood oath thingy.
Yeah, does that end in combat? Hold on.
No, it ends at the end of the day.
Okay.
It's, I think, until you take a short or long rest.
It's like, I'm totally dying. Actually, you're all right. I'm bleeding.
My blood.
I'm bleeding my own blood.
Why am I
don't know if we want to try to take a short rest here. I don't know what time of the day it is.
Well, let's check out this other potential hive of things.
Okay.
Yeah.
One thing I did mention last week is that it's actually dark.
It had been raining and overcast, and then when we got out of it, it got dark really quick.
I'll float some more.
All right, so you go into this hut. There's a big, big pot in the middle of it above a cooking fire, but the fire's not lit. There's a couple of wooden chests.
Okay, I'm gonna go check out the chests.
There's some chairs, stumps, really.
Savages.
I'm going to look at the pot. Is there anything in the pot?
It's like brown water.
Ugh. Nothing that looks appetizing. It's not French onion soup.
Some fish bones rise to the top.
Ugh. I hate fish.
All right, so you go to the first chest.
I hate fish.
These aren't they don't have locks on them. They have rudimentary clasps, but nothing that would really be a problem to open it.
All right, I'll
you open the first one and it's
bees.
Yeah, even more. It's all bees. All these bees come out of the pot.
Mouth opens to speak, and more bees come out.
There's beads and other little baubles, bone jewelry.
They're arts and crafters.
Yep.
Okay, so
is there anything valuable on the bone jewelry? Or is it just strictly made out of bones? Oh, what kind? Can we decipher what kind of bones they are from?
Are you proficient in medicine?
Probably not.
You just want to just tell me so I can.
I have +2 in medicine.
But are you proficient?
I am.
How would I know if I'm proficient in it?
It would have the star next to it.
Yeah, under your skills, the star will be lit up.
Oh, okay, duh. There's half. Nope.
All right. Then you cannot tell what kind of bones these are.
Oh.
What if somebody had a +3 but is still not proficient?
You could also not tell what kind of bones these are.
What's the roll for it?
That was a try.
Medicine.
I don't got that either.
Oh, yeah. I do.
Are they bones from a bee?
As far as you know, they are bones from many bees.
Wait, hold on. We got a swarm of bees by me and then bee bones?
Can we not give... Can we
this
not give
is why the bees are angry.
Listen, I do not want to fight skeleton bees, okay? That's a very bad deal.
Because the bees normally die when they sting things, but what about skeleton bees?
Give it up,
There's also like some shells and just pretty much like...
Is this one also dug down like the other one or no?
Yes.
Okay. What's on the shelves?
You see some axes, like some stone axes. Like a few different types of weapons, knives, arrows.
Oh, let's we should take some.
All right.
What kind of weapons do I have? Inventory.
All right. How many arrows are there?
20.
There are 20 stone arrows.
Wow. Do I have a bow? Abilities?
Wow, some things I can't use.
Wait, where does it tell me my weapons again? On inventory?
Inventory will tell you your weapons and actions will actually tell you.
I have a dagger. And a rapier. Would I be proficient in using those knives or no? Because it's like a common weapon? Are they like throwing knives?
They're more like tool knives.
Okay. You know what? I'm going to take a couple. I'm going to take like, how many knives are there?
That's not good. Oops.
There's just one knife.
There's three knives.
All right. I'll take all three. Well, I'll offer one to Chris first because he came in. Just for like in case we find something that might need a little bit of cutting. I give it to him. I give him the knife with the handle brandished towards him first. And like, eh?
Eh. Shrug. bird shrug. Take it.
All right. I'll take the second one too, and then when we leave, I'll give it to somebody else.
Okay.
Then I'll also grab. I guess I'll just grab the arrows too.
Yeah, somebody might have a use for them.
Yep. Mayhap.
You said there were knives, arrows. What else? Axes.
Yeah, like some stone, like axes.
I peek out from the hut thing and go, "Hey, does anybody need any stone axes?"
Are they throwing or are they big axes?
Hold on 1 second.
They're small hatchets.
Are they throwing or... They're you small axes?
You ask the axes that?
Yeah. No.
Well, you can throw any axe, can't you? Well, I know James can't throw axes, but...
I asked Chris, because I'm small, so I don't know what's considered a throw.
40 years in the future, me and Chris McHenry at James's gravestone still couldn't throw a damn axe.
Damn it.
So, did you say they were throwing or small axes?
They're like hatchets. You could throw them.
Every axe is a throwing axe if you try hard enough.
Yeah, so I let them know that their hatchets are so that they could possibly be thrown.
Sure. I'll try them.
All right. How many are in there?
Two.
All right. Let's grab them. And I'll grab the ear. Can I hold all this stuff? That's a good question.
Yeah.
Okay.
Put them in packs and sling them or whatever.
Yeah. Like all the arrows fill up one of your tiny little hands and then the two axe handles.
All right. I just start I start like walking out like I'm Rambo or something with all these weapons attached to me.
Right. Are you taking anything from that chest, Chris?
No, what is that noise? I hear minions talking.
Donald Duck, and it's not me.
Not me.
Jimmy and his child.
No.
Ulysses.
Ulysses.
No, I'm just taking. All I have is the knife he gave me and the lizardman stuffed plushie.
Okay.
How do I add an item to my inventory? Okay.
So, are you doing anything else in here, Chris? Or
was there anything else noteworthy in there? You said there were like shelves, the pot, the chests.
I'm just gonna make a general investigation roll and just see what's if there's anything in there.
Okay. Well, there's still another chest you haven't looked through.
Oh yeah.
Oh, let's look through that.
All right.
While he's looking through that one, I'm going to walk over here and give him the axes and offer up the knife.
Well, I'll take the axes. That works well for me. I'm not too dexterous. Knives might be better for you or someone else here.
Well, I think it's more like a hunting knife, like a skinny knife or something. Cheese knife, maybe.
I already have a couple daggers. Actually, I was going to head over.
Dave will take it.
Try speaking to the kobold in different languages. See if it recognizes any. Right. I speak common, dwarven, elvish, orcish, and infernal.
Holy crap. Infernal? Is that just like crackle, 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 pop?
It came from being an acolyte.
Oh, okay.
So you speak dwarvish, and he kind of spits at you.
And I speak two of your choice.
You speak elvish, and he kind of blows a raspberry.
I speak orcish at him, Loktar Ogar.
He jumps back against the cage.
I expose my genitals to him.
Well,
oh my god!
No, he seems. Did he seem to comprehend?
Yes.
Orcish? Okay.
Well, he seemed to comprehend, like, know of the languages of who you spoke of. And, like, who they would belong to.
Okay. Do you speak common? Asking the dragon for kobold.
But boom, I don't.
In Orcish, I ask him if he knows how tattoo works.
I just wanted to do it because it's fun.
I think he only speaks one language.
It looks neat.
I'm glad you're trying.
What about this fellow over here?
We can try to talk to the other fella in all the languages.
Hello, you.
Hold on, my pizza's done. I will return.
All right. So, swapping from the pool to the other chest. You open it up, and there's actually like a lot of coins in here. Mostly copper coins that you notice.
Okay.
And it looks like there's a few hundred. Like the size of it, you would guess that there's a few hundred coins in here.
Sweet. Is this big enough to carry? Can we?
Need help.
No. Okay. Can I drag this outside of the thing?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna drag it out to like the entrance and then just kind of squark and wave at everybody to come over and take a look at this. signal for them to come over.
When Hootsneak is doing this, does it attract the attention of either of our captives?
Yes, this one, he kind of jumps to the front of the cage. And you see, and he starts eyeing that chest. He doesn't say anything, but like you can tell he's interested in it.
Does that chest have on it? Does it look different than the other ones I found?
Nope, it is like a, just a regular wooden chest. And the bullywug is like just messing with the door on his cage, trying to figure out a way to get out of it.
We'll get back to them in a little bit. What did you find?
I kind of ring the some of the gold through my fingers, kind of raise it up. Like, and let it, like, you know, wash off, like, or just rain down.
Gold.
Well, you open his up and it's copper.
Fine is fine.
Although I don't know that, so then when he says gold, I say gold. Same way he said it. He's my mimicry to go, gold.
But this and the strange weapons you guys found there? Was there anything else?
Not really.
Right. Okay. There was some bone jewelry. There was a soup with bee bones in it.
Fish bones.
Oh, yeah, fish bones. Those ones we knew were fish bones. And then, the weapons that I brought out.
Well, let me go in there and see some of that jewelry.
Alright.
Either using, religion or medicine to tell, well, medicine to tell what sort of bones. And religion, if it has any sort of particular significance.
The bones you can tell are like lizard bones.
Okay.
They've been carved and contorted, but they still have the same like
general shape.
Yeah.
Like just lizard or like lizard person bones?
Like lizard.
Okay.
Like there's some scrimshaw in there from like large lizards. Maybe one of those guard drakes.
Okay.
And then there's also shells and beads and religious wise. You don't really
like no religious talismans or anything like up on like
there's stuff that looks like it could be, but you wouldn't know who.
Fair enough.
Like four, like in regards to.
Yeah, plus one really isn't gonna be doing much. But all right. Don't think the jewelry will be too important, but do we think that they're going to come back soon? Asking the other peeps.
I can imagine they might be back soon, and I would definitely hate that.
Yeah. That seems like, because how many did we fight prior?
There was at least three of them over there.
There was at least how many that we fought?
Well, there were three, but we didn't really do much to them. They threw a bunch of javelins at us and stuck us. And then they had some sort of weird fog and splashed off into the river on the other side, or a lake.
Yeah. And then it took us a while to just kill the one, didn't it?
Well, that was a guard drake, that big angry thing. It wasn't actually a lizard man.
Okay. Seems like, based on the number of beds and the only people that we could see, we could be up against a lot more people.
Alright. What do we do with our prisoners? Do we want to unlock them and take them with? Unlock them, set them free? Leave them to be caught? I don't really think like this without knowing that they've done something wrong.
Could we maybe bind their hands and let them go so they can't come after us easily?
We can bind their hands and take them with. They might prove to be valuable assets.
That works.
Rest of team.
I mean, I just get into the team, so
like,
I'm not...
the only reason you are on the team is because you speak English. That's different than them and
Yep.
Fair.
I think we should probably move ahead, so I'm just gonna kinda be like, I'm gonna start walking down past the big thing and just kind of wave my wing like I'm going this way.
So that's one vote for
I'm gonna follow.
Oh, that's two votes.
Yeah, I'm out of here.
Alright.
Well, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that I'm too small to monitor these prisoners, so if you guys want to do them, you can grab them, but
okay.
I'm not gonna.
McHenry, can I sneakily open these?
Yeah, go ahead.
Should I roll for it?
Roll a stealth check.
Okay.
Actually, sleight of hand.
I'm gonna do this one first.
They were messing around over here, so you have plenty of time to
Okay, sleight of hand.
Yeah.
Wait, how do I roll?
It's the, you roll the plus at the end of it. All right. Okay. You open up the lock, and the door kind of pushes open.
I do a whispery, I do a shh.
Okay. The bullywug kind of sticks his tongue out. Kind of drags it across the side of your face. He gives you a wink and he starts hopping off.
Oh god, I made a friend.
What are you doing over here? What do you have going on here?
Want to try to roll another sleight of hand?
You didn't.
All right. Dave, roll a perception check.
Oh. Well. Well.
All right, so Alistair comes walking up behind you, like, what are you doing over here? And at just that moment, you force the lock open.
Ooh.
You force the lock open. Like, you haven't opened the door for him yet, sure.
I'm expecting this wretched creature.
But why though?
What? Have you no desire to know how to kill, how to take down your enemies?
I mean, I can tell him.
We don't want to kill him, you ingrate. I would hate that. I might spend.
Well, seeing all the spinning, I'm just gonna go back over at the Birdman.
All right, before you do,
Oh, I'm stuck.
Oh. Cobalt comes out and looks at you, Alistair.
Oh, no.
Says,
Chris, my map went bye-bye. Can we make it back on my screen? Thank you.
All right. He says that to you, and then he holds out his hand.
Uh-oh.
I give him a high five.
All right. You're still
holding it. Yeah. Because
you have to put it down. After giving him a high five, he looks at you, kind of squints his eyes, like, with annoyance.
You some kind of idiot?
Blows a raspberry at you and tries to snatch that pot from you.
Okay, so he's going to catch a firebolt in the dome.
Fireball.
Okay. Go ahead and roll. Initiative.
Oh. Initiative, he says. I find initiative. There it is.
He's actually a more powerful wizard and absorbs all of your magical energy before you can even act.
I'm actually close to dead.
This is his grand exit.
Yep. Well, it's been fun, fellas.
Hold on, I gotta.
You know, if you wouldn't have blown the raspberry, you would have been fine.
Are we hearing this?
All right. So right now, take you guys out of here. All right. So you get ready to wind up and throw your firebolt at him.
Yeah.
And in that moment, he the little tunic that he was wearing. Like, just before your fireball goes out, he reaches inside of his tunic and he pulls out another one of those and throws it at your face.
Another one of the what you cut out there?
You're pretty quiet.
One of the jars of bees?
Yep.
Oh, he's double dead now.
Double bees.
And then he throws it at you. Oops, that's not the right one.
Can I dodge it?
Part of your neutral AC.
Anyone who throws a spear at me? It's like, boy, this cobalt is slick.
There's the wrong cobalt in there.
This is the doom cobalt.
All of a sudden, he's gigantic and a dragon.
And an invisible.
Okay, so that's how that works. All right, so where's the thing for swarm of bees?
Don't worry about it.
Hey, you're the one that said I'd throw a firebolt at him.
He was mouthing off.
S- swarm of bats. All right, I guess we just got to go with swarm of insects. And they're in the same spot as you.
Yep. Is it yes.
On my planet, that means hope.
You've been turned into a swarm of bees.
All right, so I gotta.
I'm pretty dexterous. Can I just catch the jar and throw it back at his dome?
That requires being a monk.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they have a snatch missiles type of ability.
All right. So now the bees go.
Yep.
All right, so they hit you for four. The bees hit you for four damage.
Those jerks. I always hated bees.
And then, oops. Little kobold runs behind the cage. It is now your turn.
Gonna move up here. I won't let me move.
Hold on. It might be.
Oh, because it was, yeah.
Oh, so the swarm.
Okay, move up there. Away from the swarm. Kind of get out of the way.
Okay. Well, you were here, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the bees get to make an attack of opportunity on you?
Are you joking? Okay.
If you disengage, then you wouldn't, but then that's your action.
No, I'm going to do like a James Bond roll.
You know, that's what the problem was, is that they had targeted themselves. I pulled a Cooper. All right.
What is that chibi voice in the background?
That was the same thing.
Wait, is that coming through my headset?
What are you watching?
3-year-old does the Team Rocket motto.
It was all on right. YouTube. So they attempt to sting you, but they don't get through your clothes.
Okay.
The bees are you're too strong for bees.
Yep. Let's say, screw you bees. I'm not into this. And then...
means
cast.
Goosh.
At what?
The cobalt.
Okay, you have to target him next time.
Oh, balls. Oh, I didn't roll as well that time, but it still hit him. Then hit for damage?
Yep.
Did he die?
No, he did not.
We hear this going on?
Yep.
Can we join Anish?
If you wish.
I ain't joining in on this.
Well, technically, Juan was still up here.
Okay.
And he saw everything.
Guess I'm roped into fighting.
No, you're not. Vaughn is.
All right.
All right. Vaughn, are you going to roll initiative as well?
Even though he gave me a hard time.
Well, you saw who started this.
Dave.
No, it was the boy who blew the razzleberry. He knows what he did.
I'm just going to keep kind of walking away from the scuffle-ish. Looking in the other direction as if I'm like, what should we do next?
All right, Michael.
Yep.
Yeah. There's danger. 6-. Do I have to athletics check to jump down?
Nah, it's short enough. It's not 10 feet, so.
And this is difficult terrain here in the water?
Yep.
Okay. I think that's as far as I get. Hey, wait, stop. Who, what? Trying to get them to not kill each other.
All right. Arthur, it's your turn.
Get them bees.
How does shooting at bees with a bow and arrow work?
They take like half damage as a swarm.
Even though I have elemental stuff on my bow?
Yep.
Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. Here's what we are going to do. We are going to shoot an arrow at these bees. Shift.
Control. Control left click.
Did it work?
You know what?
That seemed to work, or did you do that?
I don't see your thing going. Here, let me do something real quick.
It's the whole screaming noises. Like somebody's been torturing like minions or something.
I think I need to turn up my feedback settings.
Just roll it and I'll figure it out.
Okay. Then it'll add my modifier, right?
I don't think yours did. But it's plus what? Like, I'm figuring everything out on this end, so I'll tell you if you hit or not, and then I'll do the damage. And so just roll your attack.
Okay. Can you just click on it?
Yep.
That's a nat 20.
It is, against the bees.
Oh!
Roll damage.
It's a bee kebab.
I'm going to catch all of them with one little
swing. All right, and then does the D4 get double two that he does?
Dice normally double in critical hits, but not modifiers.
Okay. So then roll 2d4.
D4, can I? There you go.
If you right-click, it'll, yep. Okay, so that was a total of 8 plus 6 is 14, half to 7.
The bolt flares as it goes through the clutching bees and skewering them.
Yep. You hit like 6 bees.
Out of
100 bees.
That's a lot of bees.
No, you hit like 7 bees out of 22 bees.
Okay, that's nice to know.
See what I did there, right?
Mm.
They have total HP, might be something near that.
All right. Which one of these fun things do I want to grab out of this thing of my stuff? Skunk in the cage. Anyway. Let's not do that. All right, I guess I'll just hit you with a scorpion on a stick. So he reaches into the stump and he pulls out this like 3-foot stick, and at the end of it is a scorpion tied to it.
Are you okay?
What is that from?
What is what from?
You have to murder something, but you have to use it's like a wombat on a stick.
All right. So you take this 1 piercing damage. And you got to save versus this, which you do not. So you take 1 more poison damage.
It bends.
What are you complaining about, James?
Hmm?
What are you complaining about?
Well, no, the scorpion sting. It bends.
Oh, they said, hey, friends. I was like, I'm not coming.
No.
No, 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 no.
All right.
Baby, give it up.
All right, so they're going to swarm over to here. There.
No. What are you guys swarming about?
Trying to target you. Alright, there's something going on with you so that I can't target you. So I'm just going to roll the attack and you tell me if it hits you.
Like on pen and paper. Does 8 hit me?
It does not hit you.
It does not hit me.
I know an 8 doesn't hit you.
Well, way to assume.
Yeah, I assumed your AC.
My AC can use whatever the bathroom it wants.
That's fair, but an 8 still won't hit it. Alistair, it's your turn.
Okay.
And you are hurting now, so, very bad.
What do you mean?
Well, you've taken 10 points of damage out of your 12 total.
Do we have a healer?
I can kind of heal, but we used up a good part of our chunk in the first encounter.
Interesting. Okay, give me a
second. You might want to disengage and back off peacefully.
He blew raspberries at me.
And you decided to cast a firebolt at it.
Look what you did.
And look how it's turning out for you.
All right,
what'd you do to this session? I don't know. Dave fought something in a fucking cage. Dave's reenacting the fucking Nicolas Cage movie over here.
Ha! Cage.
Enters Thunderdome.
Did you just target yourself and it for a
attacking girls?
For a burning hands?
Do I need to? Do I need to redo it?
Well, he saved versus it, so
I'm so confused. Yeah, I don't know why I was doing that.
Because you have yourself targeted?
I do? I don't think I do. Oh, maybe I do.
Alright. Succeeded his save.
So I don't know what that means.
He takes half damage.
Okay.
And doesn't catch on fire.
But you tried, bud. You real tried.
Is Dave gonna die?
Maybe.
Maybe.
Are you and Mommy getting a divorce?
Alright, he's still up and fighting.
Damn it.
And he's looking Cooper, just as bad as you. House.
Save me!
Alright. So start of the third round. The wizard you found in a cage is fighting a kobold you found in a cage.
And they're both almost dead?
And they're both almost dead.
Boot sneak, Piven, come on.
Let's save them.
The person well, there's you also know, you in
cover, wait, too. Save who? Save who?
Yeah, who are we? What? No, what?
The person you do know is being swarmed by bees.
Arthur is in trouble.
I'm so sorry.
My allies, send aid.
He's flailing at the bees.
My hair grows.
And you don't know why this happened.
No. You know why.
But
you know what this was.
But you did see earlier that the wizard that you just met did open a jar full of bees earlier.
Shallow and pedantic.
Yeah. He could be shallow and pedantic. All right. Starting the third round. I just wanted to go over, you know, what's going on.
Let me roll for initiative here.
Are we rolling each round, or are we just going? Oh,
I haven't rolled yet.
Okay.
I roll good.
Mama says we can buy a Hyundai if we're good.
I have a lot of questions.
All right. I don't know why these are...
Right. Bloodlust, fuck you.
Cooper, try targeting something.
Control left? What, shift?
Control, left click.
I cannot target anything.
Alright, why is this nuts?
What if I do like this? But I can put a dark circle around people.
Save me.
Oh. What?
All right, try again.
Okay. There we go.
Okay, you can. Okay, it's not showing for me, but if you're seeing it, then it's fine.
Yeah. All right. So I can move 25. Well, but this is difficult terrain. So how much is each square?
Two squares, basically.
So I could go about here.
Yep.
Okay. What's the state of Vaughn or Arthur?
He's about the same. Still hurt. Okay. Remember, you're out of spells.
Oh, wait, no, I'm not out of all spells.
No, you still have Vicious Mockery.
Yeah.
No, I could have done the bees.
Yeah.
My intelligence may be low, but not that low. Where are my spells, abilities? Nope. Skills? No. Is it abilities?
Whoa.
Where are my spells? How do I find those again?
Under actions, I think.
Actions, all right. So I could still do...
Friends?
Wait, where's my Bardic Inspiration one?
You can only do that a number of times equal to
Charisma.
Yeah.
I thought that one was considered a cantrip.
No, it's charisma mod per day.
Yeah.
Oh, that one's a different lock. Okay.
Yeah.
Wait, no, not Vicious Mockery on Dave. Hold on. Let's try that again. There we go. Click the shield, right?
Or no.
Double click the star? Nope.
What are you trying to do?
Cast Vicious Mockery on the imp or kobold.
All right. Given your size, I'm going to say you can't actually see him from down there.
Oh.
Because they're up on the hill.
Yeah, it was like 5 to 6 feet up.
All right, well, I tried. Fair enough.
All right. Bromos, it is your turn.
Okay. Still have to get across here. Standard move gets me that far. Dash to try to climb up the hill. Telling everyone, like, stop. Hey. And once I get up there, I have my shield. I will draw my warhammer and look towards like the swarm.
Look to the sky.
That's what I got for the moment. Next.
All right. Kobold goes next. Sorry, Arthur goes next.
What was this disengage ability?
If the standard action is disengage, it allows you opportunity. It's your action to... Go ahead.
Sorry, it just cut out. So if I go disengage...
You can move up to your movement rate.
Disengage.
Do you move like 35 or... No, that is 30. Okay.
But that's your action for the turn.
That's fine.
Run from the bees!
Look at the giant lizard thing. I mean, would you just kill us with bees?
All right. It's the kobold's turn.
No, boy.
I don't like being in a straight line here. Go on, here we go. Back.
All Okay, so I've used wasp nest in a bag, scorpion on a stick. All right, let's use skunk in a cage.
Smoking a pancake.
Wrong in a blitz.
All right, I don't think I have a token for skunks. So we're just going to use the zero.
Naturally.
He's getting shamaned.
And he's going to disengage.
Oh. Wait, what was the O? The
zero? It's a bunch of skunks.
Not a bunch, it's just one.
Oh, okay.
Is it friendly?
It wants to mark you.
I want to know if I can befriend it. And then together we'll team up a wizard and a skunk and defeat this kobold.
Is there a cat? Okay, we're going to use the cat statistics.
Kitty. I'll name it Flower.
Wait, where'd the cat come from?
Meow.
It's the skunk.
You nut your manga down with the sickness.
Right. Biscuit.
All right, so then the skunk goes next.
Or Nickelback.
All right. All right, so it sprays a random creature within 5 feet of it. Dave.
Go on.
So you did a DC 9 Constitution save, which you failed. The target retches and can't take actions for 1 minute.
Oh, man.
The target can repeat the saving throw at the end of each of its turns, ending the effect on itself in a success. Creature that doesn't need to breathe or is immune to poison automatically succeeds. Alright, and once the skunk has sprayed its musk, it can't do so again until it finishes a short or long rest. Dave, you just got skunked.
Alright.
Got a stinky butt.
Well, that stinks.
Wah, 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 wah.
Wah.
BRB, BRB 1 sec, I have to run to the bathroom.
All right, now it's the bees.
Save Vaughn.
Save the rainforest. Forget about me, guys.
And,
oh, speed 20. Man, right. They come after you, James.
Ooh, bees!
But they don't get within range of you, so you can see this big swarm of bees. Really, with like 13 bees.
That's a lot of bees.
And they're flying at you, and there's a skunk in front of Alistar, who's like throwing up all over the place.
Did the skunk run off after spraying them or no?
Well, it's still there.
Oh.
The kobold ran off.
Whose turn is it?
It would be Alistair's turn.
But I can't do it, right?
Nope. At the end of your turn, roll a constitution save.
Okay. He dies by skunk smell. Skunk.
Well, he's been poisoned and stung and strayed.
Question, if I just hit the dice next to constitution, is that the same thing?
Yes.
No, it's on the other side.
On the left hand side?
On the right side.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Hmm.
Well, that didn't go as planned.
You're still retching.
Ugh.
Your eyes are starting to water up. It's just terrible.
It's like your cousin's 15th bar mitzvah party.
Not even sure what that means, but I'm not going to deny you.
But all right, Piven, it's your turn.
Already dead.
I move to the bank, and I kind of pull myself up to look. Like, just start looking over the edge and see what's going on.
I assume
I can see the bees and the skunk.
And the throwing up wizard.
And the throwing up wizard. And the kobold is gone.
Yeah.
Can't, like, okay, outside of, can Vicious Mockery pull aggro or no?
No. There is no aggro in this game. Unless okay. I say so.
And oh. I don't say so.
Well, it will give them disadvantage on their next attack.
Yeah. Can I Vicious Mockery them as a whole?
Stupid bees. Your honey sucks.
We're not going to save you.
Don't steal my thunder.
I hate you bees.
Yeah, so I'm gonna do that.
you taunt the bees. You're like, at least you got wasps.
Think they do a wisdom save for that?
We might be wasps.
You'll never but I have to roll my wasp first, right?
Also, Dave, you can totally stay over.
Oh, sweet! Thank you.
I totally just remembered you asked me.
We have a bed here too. If you need to stay here too.
Now it's gonna be a competition.
So how do I roll it?
My mom's gonna make you all this food.
Fuck.
There's a save button.
She's a good
like
cook
press
too.
The magnifying glass and it opens up everything.
I can't.
Oh, there it is. Okay,
cast.
All right. Here's Cooper right now.
I wanna make
right. You've heard of YouTube. What's up?
I wanna make him mad. Cooper's got bees on his pee-pee.
Yeah, we wouldn't want the bees to get mad.
I hate you bees. Unregistered hypercam 2. How old is this video?
Put him back in the hive. Yeah, all right, enough is enough. That's from a TED TV program called The Family Guy, Dave.
Oh yeah,
it's kind of like Rich and Mitchy, but better.
All right.
I can see the end of this video happening.
Oh my god! All
right, so you Vicious Mockery them. They fail. So roll damage.
It's a D4 of fury.
Oh.
Oh.
Bit of a maverick over here.
All right. Don't really want to brag, but.
Well, you killed a bee with your voice.
Did one of them commit suicide from how much I hate it?
What just falls out of the sky, like twirling to the ground?
You make me sad.
It I hate you. Into a small explosion. All right, Bromos, it's your turn.
All right. First off, I'll move down here. And it's control.
Yep. There might be an issue. There might be an issue. Like, I have to probably reset the whole thing.
All right. I have my shield up and my Warhammer ready. So. Rah! Is that it?
13. It does hit.
Excellent. Yeah.
All right.
I don't have any bonus actions. And I'll actually move over here afterwards a little bit. That's me.
All right. Arthur, it's your turn.
Ooh, let's get in these guts. So, am I shooting into friendly space? Is there a possibility they hurt my friends?
They do get cover for you shooting through an ally.
You might be able to move to get a clear shot somewhere.
What about here?
Kind of a weird shot, because they're above you.
Maybe if you instead went around the campfire.
If you go like this over to here, you could shoot him.
That seems good, God.
You're welcome.
Go to the jungle.
Thank you, Lord. All right, so you're shooting the bees again?
Yep, shooting at the bees. You mean just roll? D20?
Yep.
I refuse to participate in this bee combat.
Are you a bee pacifist?
Do you bee chillin'? Do you love
13 hits. Savior, Lord?
Cool.
Do you not get like a bonus or anything?
I get blood ray, don't I?
Well, that's for damage. Oh, okay. Oh, no, it's also a plus one weapon with that, I believe.
Yeah, but you didn't roll where you'd have... Did you just roll the d20 on the bottom?
Yeah.
If you go into actions, you should have your in there.
Yeah.
All right, well, 13... magic. So, roll damage.
I need that to stop. Okay, roll damage. That's a D4.
Oh, well, plus your crossbow, right? Okay, so plus a D4.
Where's my D4 at?
Right click on the screen and arrange dice.
Okay, arrange dice. Wait, what?
Oh, God.
Wow.
Custom dice.
All right, so 60 divided by half.
30. Wait.
Let's roll them all.
I don't know where to get my D4 back, guys.
Okay, so right click on your background.
Yeah.
And to the
really makes you think.
All right. Given that I don't want to have an hour long combat of you guys versus bees.
Yeah. They suddenly died.
They fly away.
All the bees.
All right.
Now there is just a skunk and a throwing up wizard.
Sounds like my college days.
Well, let's just drag the wizard away. The skunk will go somewhere. Just the skunk.
But what if I want to befriend the skunk?
I think it has already chosen you as no.
Or was that a spray of love?
Nope, you've already been friend zoned.
Oh. Fine. Relatively fruitless.
So.
Well, maybe you shouldn't go throwing firebolts at people.
Did we actually loot the chest of the copper? Did that go into like party fund?
I assumed it would. It has not yet. So.
All right. Let's see. Run sheet inventory.
I got it.
Okay.
Well, we need to play 7 days against Tomb.
We do need to just play some video games in general.
Yep.
Yeah. It's, the only problem is Emma's been for Warcraft.
Do I need to join Warcraft again? Because I'll do it.
Yeah, we just got to level 86.
Okay.
Oh, somebody's not in this yet. Oh well, he didn't get any copper. He got skunked instead.
No.
So
we can't trust him yet,
Dave. I am ravenous after a.
What are you ravenous after?
Oh, hey, don't forget to divvy out those weapons.
I haven't nutted in a month.
Yeah, neither have I.
Are those your whispers I can hear, Chris?
I don't know.
No, Chris, Preston, when with from No Nut November.
The what? Yeah, we're in the hive mind right now. You've entered the hive mind. Welcome, brother.
Don't talk about hives right now.
Tomorrow is too many bees. Destroy your dick December.
We were following a trail that ended up over this way.
Yep.
Do we think that the trail or here?
One second. Let me just get all of this.
I'm honestly not convinced the trails exist.
The reality is we don't exist.
But Preston, let's just talk about the just community and the brotherhood that we all shared.
There's three knives and two hatchets, right?
I've honestly felt like more energy like this whole month.
Since we defeated No Nut November, since we got me to Never Nut again.
Well, oh yeah, that was a whole triumph. Actually, the main thing we got to talk about is what I honestly think we need to fuse next year. Your big boy barbecue with cucked admin meetup.
We had Will there this year, so that was one.
Right, I think you really need to sell it as like a thing everybody's getting together for.
Guys, we need you guys to come out. Yeah, no, I can definitely get that going. Like, really be like, hey guys, first serious post on the page. Come to this barbecue in Kenosha. It's a good group of boys.
All right, there. All the stuff's assigned.
Cool, now I have all damage types. Yay. But yeah, we need to try to either pick up that trail, find some sort of place that's safe, because lizardmen are going to come back, and we need to heal up. Searching the area for tracks that seem to be the same trail that we were working with.
All right. The tracks led you here, and then, like, tracks going out, you see that there's numerous that they go out, they go in.
Alright. Is the woods, like, pretty thick here?
You are near, like, the lake itself.
Alright.
So it'd be like that, how you'd go out to the beach, and there'd be that tree line there that goes out into the woods.
If there's a particularly tall tree, Hootsneak, could you like climb up and see if there's some sort of structure or something in the distance?
Wark? I'll point up to it. I'll nod and look around and see if there's a higher, like a tree I can kind of scoot up.
Roost, damn it. For your father's sake,
there,
roost.
Is there a tree I can look up into?
Yep. You, like you climb up a tree, like just to the north of it a little bit. You do see a clearing, like a couple miles away. Like it looks like it could be the road.
Okay.
Because that the clearing is going along enough that it could be a road, but you can't quite make it out from here.
But we have at least a general direction.
Yeah. I was going east.
Yeah, I kind of point in that direction.
Or, sorry, west. The lake is to the east.
Do we think we want to go that way? See if there's...
I've realized I'm poor bad decisions, so I'm just not going to answer.
I'll follow you, James. You seem sensible.
Hold on. Since I'm next to Alistair here, he looks really hurt.
Oh, his bones.
My bones.
Use 5 hit points to lay on hands on him.
All right.
Hands.
I've got like 5 hit points left. Otherwise, I'm completely out of healing.
Cool.
Okay. Where are you at, Arthur?
At healing points?
Hit points.
I am at 8 hit points. Or I've taken 8 hit points?
Yeah, you've taken 8.
So I'm at 4 hit points.
Okay. Stick by me, and if we can get to a short rest area, that'll be helpful. Otherwise, I'll lay on hands if we run into another encounter.
Okay.
So, trying to find a trail that should head off into the direction of the clearing.
All right.
I don't know who's really good at, like, wilderness tracking.
What about the rest of you? Are you following him out into the woods?
Yeah. I follow James to death.
All right.
He's committing himself to the river Styx.
He said stay close to you.
I'm up here on the hill.
Yes.
Which is all right. Where I am.
Okay.
So you guys dig through the woods, and eventually you get to the road. It looks like it's the main road through the marsh.
Okay.
And if you would follow it north, you'd probably get back to Boughton.
Well, hey, at least we know a way back. Mm-hmm. Oh. When we were going along the road, did we remember like any or other inns or things along it?
What do you mean inns?
Any sort of like way stop or any sort of civilization?
You would have all come from the north.
Okay. So. This is south of it?
Yeah.
We're supposed to check in the general area. It might be good to see along the road, see if anyone else has been attacked. So, want to head away from Boughton for a bit?
Yeah, we can head away from Boughton for a bit.
It is getting to, like, looking up at the skies, you do see, notice that it is getting to be night now.
All right, then finding some sort of spot where it's semi-safe to make a camp.
All right. Just off the road, like, you can make a camp just off the road and... Like with watches and stuff, you assume that it can be pretty safe.
Yeah.
Let's make first watch.
Well, you need to set up camp and stuff. Hopefully it's not all soggy and marshy.
For the most part, it's going to be soggy and marshy, but it'll do.
Go.
It'll do, Pig. It'll do.
All right, and you're back up to 14 hit points.
Really? Donkey.
Does anybody have a bow?
I have a crossbow. Grid.
I'm strength based, so I throw things at enemies.
You could probably draw back a bow string.
What's my
Chris might have a short bow.
Never.
I believe I do.
Taking first watch. Or Arthur is. I'll take second watch.
Alright. Which watch am I first?
It's your choice. Do you have dark vision?
No, he doesn't.
Cooler if you did.
Can I line my orbs up? Or my orb and send it floating around?
Do you have the light cantrip or dancing lights?
Good question.
Wait, I have prestidigitation.
Well, that can set campfires to make small little lights for a little, like, 6 seconds. Well, no, it can make some things for an hour, but it's really small, like little glowy tattoo or someone.
I'll do it.
That'd be under actions, then.
Yeah, I think during standard stuff, it's just roleplay. But
yeah. It's whether or not you have
light roleplay. Just get the mood going.
I can make a shower of sparks, a puff of wind, faint musical notes, or an odd odor.
Where are you seeing this?
Eating too much fish.
Can I make an odd odor that'll make Dave actually smell better?
That's true. You will attract. You may attract things because of, you know.
Yeah.
Or you may scare things away.
Oh.
Or.
I can chill, warm, or flavor up to 1 cubic foot of non-living material for an hour.
So you can make stew actually taste like stew rather than fish.
Yes.
Everything tastes like chicken.
Yeah.
Except the chicken.
I can make a color, a small mark, or a symbol appear on an object or a surface for an hour.
Oops, ripping fake vapes.
Who vaping?
I see nothing but horrible facial tattoos in the future.
Let's give Dave a little smiley face on his forehead.
Hey!
It's a weird smiley face. It looks like an X that's bent to the right.
Like in the Wolverine film.
Yeah.
Are we just using rations, or are we okay with trying to gather food? I think we're kind of beat up. We might just want to use rations for a night. Yeah.
Was there anything salvageable from that stew, or no?
I don't know. Are you walking back to find out?
Yeah.
That's a way back.
Okay, fine. They look kind of gross anyways.
No, we have some rations, so we can eat some food.
Yeah, some laminin bread.
How many Julie?
Yay, more laminin bread.
I love Lord of the Rings.
Do we encounter?
The night passes like uneventfully. You hear the sounds of wildlife out in the marsh, but you don't see any, like, nothing comes by.
Alright.
Do I heal at all?
Yeah, I've already.
If you get a successful long rest, you heal up.
Okay. Back to business.
Yay!
Taking care.
All right, so the morning comes around, sun's breaking through the tree line, and it's actually the first time you've seen the sun in days.
Praise the sun!
We're not in England anymore.
Indeed.
What are you guys doing?
Well, we could continue south on the road. Does this seem like it might loop back around the lake at all?
You couldn't tell from here. It's a very large lake.
Well, the road will be easier and less time-consuming to take, so we can explore that for a while. And if we're not finding anything, then we'll have to try to get back to the lake and circle around and see if we find something there.
Sure.
So if you guys have other ideas...
I point toward the road, because it seems like the simplest way to go.
But which way on the road? Back towards Boughton, or farther away from Boughton?
To adventure.
How many? We were out one day from Boughton.
Yep.
Then let's continue further away, because the road back would just be quick.
All right. So you guys start traveling down the road. You walk probably 2 miles or so on this road. It's uneventful. Like, you see like wagon tracks and like footprints, but nothing like weird or off.
Okay.
In about midday, you notice down, like down the road from you, a small red-skinned lizard fellow.
Does he notice us?
He has not yet.
Quietly hide? See what he's doing?
Guess? As you get closer to him, though, you notice it's the kobold.
Ah, that kobold.
He spreads his ass cheeks and bees come flying out of
him. All right. Maybe trying to peacefully talk with him rather than firebolting him at range. That'd be an idea. All
right. So you get about 50 feet from him. You can all close that map.
How do we close it?
There's like an X at the top of it.
You have to like pull it down.
Yeah. Ah, I see it now. Alright.
Oh, I can just do that too.
Pull away my Warhammer. Seem to look peaceful. Use persuasion if we're going to approach him and talk with him. Uh-oh. It's a road!
Alright. What's your marching order?
Hold on.
I'm gonna be in the frontish.
Well, I'm the one of the rangers, so I shall be...
I was kind of marching people this way, so...
There's actually a tab on the party sheet for marching order.
Yeah. So how do you guys want it?
Oh, there we go.
Deep.
Watch order. Wait.
Put me near the back.
I'll head up towards the front.
I'll be in the front, too.
Second from the back.
Who's on top?
Coop's in the middle.
All right, fine. I'll be in the middle. Persuasive.
Oh, that's just on watch order.
Yeah, it says watch order. I don't see that. Oh, wait.
You can draw on this map, but...
Oh, next, I bet we probably have to grab ourselves?
Ooh. Yeah.
That just moves my screen little thing. Huh?
Dave, how'd you get on there?
I dragged onto it from the player.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Dave, what sorcery is this?
Don't worry about it.
Dave, what are you doing?
Literally nothing. That's the magic of it.
Alright.
Dave's just sitting there pantsless, just we're doing it. We're playing the Dungeons and Dragons.
Dungeoning and dragoning.
Just pantsless with a blazer and sunglasses on.
American dream is a lot.
Talking about the dream.
All right, there's actually like two grids on here that you just kind of ignore the old one.
BRB.
So let's do this way. Are we doing like that, or?
Seems fine.
Or are we doing three abreast and then the two in the back?
That could be okay, too.
All right. Now, how do I drag that over to the thing? That's what I want to know. There's got to be a reason for it.
Did you, like, draw, edit around it, and then, like, cut, paste?
Nah, I don't think so. I don't think that's going to work. Yeah, whatever. Just going to drag you guys down there.
I'm back.
Yeah, see Matt Lauer did a bad thing.
Yeah.
Who hasn't done a bad thing?
Nobody. He had a button on the desk that instantly locked the door.
I guess that's like a common thing, though. I guess like all the like producers have this like rape room.
That's scary.
I don't know if that necessarily was meant to be a rape room.
It's like one of those escape rooms that Dave keeps talking about.
Oh.
That's the room of no escape.
No, the escape rooms I talk about are like a game where you have a puzzle and there's nothing nefarious afoot. It's just... it's fun.
That sounds like something a nefarious person would say.
I was hoping that my vocabulary would calm the subject down.
Oh, all right. Man, that just cracked. I'm dead.
So you guys notice him, and he actually notices you.
Hello, you.
And he kind of blows another raspberry. From the distance you see, he blows another raspberry at you guys.
This guy's a little shit.
See, this is why I tried to fight him.
It's this fucking attitude.
Kids these days.
Hand up.
And all of a sudden, like while he's doing that, you guys hear a crashing coming from the marsh behind him.
Towards you.
Great.
Ready, shield, and warhammer.
And he doesn't notice it because he's fixated on you.
Run!
Yeah, can we run?
Well, no, yelling at him.
And through like a couple of trees, out comes this giant.
It's the bully mong.
It is a giant.
That lizard man that looks like his arms reach from like his shoulders at which are at like 10 feet high down to the ground.
Yeah.
Like his face mighty is like, young. Like wide and like his face is like wide and flat like an alligator's.
Oh boy.
That looks dangerous.
Talking about that man, she's butler.
And he, before you know it, like before like you motion to the kobold to run and he just reaches out, grabs the kobold in one hand and picks him up. With his other hand, he grabs him around the throat and he just rips.
Satisfied.
Aww.
Looks like he blew his last raspberry. He died doing what he loved.
Being a shit.
Being a little shit.
So he almost killed me, so we should probably run.
Are we on a niche?
Yep, I'll roll it for everybody.
Okay.
I'm sorry, say that again. Are you rolling our initiative?
Yep.
Okay.
And he looks at you and he just lets out this deep guttural roar.
If it was three octaves lower, it would sound like what the dinosaurs sounded like.
Yep.
How do you know that?
Tyler's a secret caveman.
He's going to school to be a paleontologist.
To teach other paleontologists how to be paleontologists.
No, actually, true facts, Cooper was that little kid that Sam Neill taught about velociraptors at the beginning of Jurassic Park.
Real sharp.
All right. So what do you do, Hootsneak? You're first.
Just barrel roll right into him and die. No.
Screw the shot.
Tastes like chicken.
Just gonna corkscrew right into him. Like a fucking bird
drill.
Bird Mario drill. Odyssey? Yeah, I'm gonna bird drill into him. No, let's see. Well, I think I'm gonna shoot him because it looks like he'd like eat me like a chicken. So, can I, I kind of want to get in this tree over here. How far can I get?
Wait,
into
before
this
he leaves, I quick toss my arrows.
I already got arrows. Okay.
Oh, did you get my arrows though? No. I had 20 of them.
No, I still got 20. I haven't shot anything yet with my bow.
This could be a long fight.
Another orb.
All right. I want to try and move over into like this tree here.
Alright.
So what would I be rolling to get, like, let's see, how far, 1, 5, 10, 15, and then how far can I get up this tree?
I'd be half movement going up.
And how high can I get?
So you have 15 high. Feet left, you could get 5 feet up the tree.
Okay, then I will get 5 feet up this tree.
You could use your cunning action being second level to dash, which gives you more move.
Can I dash up this tree? Like a ninja?
Can you fly up it? You're a bird.
No, I'm like a big fucking penguin. That doesn't happen.
You're like a big bird.
I'm a big bird. Big bird does not fly. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna try and dash up there then.
Alright, so you get about 15 feet into the tree. Like you're in the branches. What are you doing while in the tree?
I Hiding, shooting, pooping.
I'm hooting. I'm going to try and shoot the guy, but I don't think I have enough actions to do that, right?
You still have a standard.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Can I shoot him with the short bow? What's...
He's only 40 feet away.
I'd hope so.
Watch out.
So you control left click on him.
Yeah. Okay. Whoops. There we go. Control left. There we go. Why is it? Oh, there we go. Okay. Watcha.
Okay.
All right. There we go. All
right. Roll damage.
So just drag it twice?
Or... No, you just you go to the damage, and then you just drop it on the thing. Or you just double-click the damage.
A mighty 9.
All right. You get a arrow into his shoulder. It sinks in. He just kind of looks down at it. And then looks back up at the tree.
I immediately form a nest and lay an egg and go, brah! I look around like I don't know what was going on. Just a simple big bird in a tree.
You've obviously angered him.
Well,
sorry, it. You can't tell gender from sight. Sorry, Vaughn. Sorry.
Thank you.
It has no peen, but giant balls that just sway in the air.
They could be feminine balls.
The beautiful feminine balls. Okay, I'm done. I'm done making it mad. You guys' turn.
Alistair Black.
What are you, a magician in Vegas?
Yes.
Make sure it's on waitress.
No, he's a professional wrestler that I guess loses to Dollar General Goldust.
Oh.
I listen to his theme song like literally every day going to work.
How do I tell how far something is?
Click on it.
Should be like 60 feet.
Yeah. So let me do the thing.
What are you trying to do?
Like, I'd like to move over here, but I want to know how far it is.
It's 4 squares.
Okay, 1, 2.
Every square is 5 feet.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Okay, I'm going to hide kind of underneath the base of this tree.
Okay.
Like behind it. And then I want to take a shot.
All right, go ahead.
Hang on, I think I'm posing it up. Did I target him? Oh, hang on.
Now you're not. You were before.
Now I've targeted him, right?
Not according to mine.
Sorry.
There, targeted him for you.
Okay. And then I would like to do actions. I think Witch Bolt can hit him from here, can it?
I forget the range on Witch Bolt.
Yeah, that's.
But you should be within 30 feet, which
range is 30 feet. Okay, then, so I'll try.
Yeah,
I'll do it then. I'll cast a Witch Bolt. Not going to hit, probably.
It does not hit.
Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm. All right.
That's me.
Arthur, it is your turn.
Okay, I run up here. How far is this?
It's 20 feet, so you're 30 feet from him.
Is that enough range? Is that's enough range, right?
For what?
shooting my crossbow.
Oh, yeah.
It's like 80 feet.
Yeah, that'd be like all the way at the back end here.
Okay, well, I say face. I will be your nightmare and your undoing. Thanks for ruining it.
Just add it to it.
Does the 13 hit?
No.
Not.
I shoot wide.
All right. It's its turn.
The gator.
Oh, boy.
All right. This rock, it just picks up like it's a mere pebble. And it takes it and it just chucks it at this tree. Not aiming to hit you, but to hit the tree. And it crashes into the tree.
Fuck.
It's not enough to break the tree itself.
All right.
But it shakes it to its very core. I need you to make a dexterity save.
Alrighty then.
This is gonna ruffle his feathers.
Oh boy.
Whee! Squawk!
The force of it knocks you out of the tree.
Shit!
And you were 15 feet up, so that's 2d6 falling damage. Alright, so you take 5 points of falling damage.
Thub.
And you're on the ground.
His ranged attack was a little bit more impressive than mine. I have X's over my eyes and stuff. Oh, little eggs that are cracking and little cartoon eggs.
Piven, do you roll?
Brumos, it is your turn.
All right. Let's see. 1, 2, 3.
Also, that rock is no longer there. But I can't get it.
Ready. Okay, I'm targeting them.
Yourself too, or?
No. Do I control left on me? Am I targeting? No, okay.
I was just asking.
Shield to cast bless?
The magnifying glass opens.
Okay.
And then you would cast it, and they should get that effect.
So just click on the effect button?
Yes. Or the cast button. It either should work. Yep.
Okay. That was my move, and that. Pull Warhammer, have my shield out, yell at the thing, trying to get it to focus on me. That's my go.
Piven, it is your turn.
Oh, dear. I wish I had a bow.
I wish.
Is there a bow, Lena?
You know, I had a bow, but it really didn't do much. But give me a rock chuck at me.
Taunting it would actually really help because it gives a disadvantage.
Yeah. Let's see.
But you might need to get closer to pull that off.
Let's see. So I was here. How much is each square? 10 feet.
Five.
Oh, five. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Dink. Yeah, let's do it. Phew. Alright,
Ooh. You do have your Bardic Inspirations as well.
Now, where do I find that on my stuff? Because...
Yeah, under abilities, maybe?
Yeah, it'll... there's not something for you to cast it.
Oh, okay. Let's see. Who do we think can do the most damage here? Probably I'll be able to Bromos.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. Bardic Inspiration on him.
Right.
You can use this feature a number of times equal to your charisma modifier, a minimum of once.
Procure my coat of battle.
We lost Fawn. You regain any expanded uses when you finish long.
Ruhu.
Okay. So, how do I cast it on him?
For this, there's a thing you get.
Okay.
Because there's really not a way to track it in here.
Okay, then I do that.
All right, and we lost Vaughn.
Vaughn!
Where'd you go?
There you go.
All right, who's speak? It's your turn.
Forever.
You are king blessed.
Alright. I'm gonna try and sweep myself off here. I'm actually gonna try and get back in a tree, or is this tree like just fucking wrecked?
It's wobbly.
Okay. Then I think I'm gonna move where I can get a shot at this. What is this little okay, so hold on, let me see. I got, what's my speed? 30? Let me see here. 5. Can I move there?
Yeah.
Okay. Is Bromos in the way here, or can I shoot him? Or can I shoot
him? No, you can shoot him.
Okay. Then I am going to take another shot at him.
You get a d4.
It should do it automatically on your attack.
Okay. Whoops. I cannot hit a fucking broadside of a barn. All right. A 12.
Your shot goes wide.
And then can I use that other move that, that...
The cutting action?
Yeah, to move again?
Yep.
Okay, and then how far is
Vaughn
that?
Vaughn got a blue screen.
It gives you a dash, which is basically your movement again.
Okay, then... I'm gonna move here. That's where I'm gonna move.
Alright.
That's it for me.
Alright. Alistair, it's your turn.
I'm going to move back here and try to hide behind this tree. I'll still be able to see the gator. And then I'm going to shoot a chromatic orb at him.
All right.
Crit?
Yeah, baby.
All right. So
yeah, baby.
What should I do? Should I do acid, cold, fire, lightning, poison, thunder?
Lizards are cold-blooded.
What does that mean?
They don't like cold.
Huh, we'll do cold. There's 7 cold damage.
Alright. He screams out in pain.
Nice.
Scared of my aura. That's all I got.
All right. Arthur's turn, which for this, I'm going to say he takes a shot.
Has he ignited his weapon today?
He hasn't, but he hadn't before, so.
Hmm.
And it's, he only gets the one weapon that he can do it to, so.
Yeah. Well, he has to pay for each one if he was going to.
So he takes another shot and shoots at him. Hitting him right in the chest. He's like, you can see the blood covering him from like his shoulder down.
Fuck.
It is the Gator's turn. Makes his way down here. And this tree that he's standing to, he actually uproots it. Picks it up over his head and has you all lined up perfectly for him. He chucks it at you. I'm going to need everybody to make dexterity saves.
Three.
Jeez, we'll just...
I think we all pick the tree.
Stand in the AOE.
Hootsneak, you actually had a bonus D4. Not that it would help much, but...
Yeah, because they're saves, not checks.
Oh, whoops.
There you go. There you go.
All right.
So, from the weight of this tree hitting, slamming into each and every one of you, get knocked out to the side.
It's literally an anime.
It is. Like, and you all, like, lose consciousness for, like, a second, but by the time you come to, he's gone.
Oh. No!
I wanted him to kick my ass more.
You do see the big thunderous, like, prints, like, tracks leading down the road in the direction of Boughton.
Well, let's give chase.
Yeah, I'm game for that.
Pick yourselves up. Did we take damage from that, or was it
just, It was just, like it was a cinematic,
Oh, okay. We don't know how long we've been out, but...
You follow the tracks for about 100 feet or so. And they kind of just, you notice that they stop being the gigantic reptilian tracks, and they look more like human booted tracks.
That's interesting.
What is going on?
And that's where we're going to end it tonight.
Hey, boy.
It's we're fucked chasing up. The indomitable Krunk.
Holy shit.
Just need to give you guys a taste of what's to come.
We handled it easily, obviously.
I mean, I tackled it with 37 damage.
I wasn't expecting an hour-long bee fight, but...
You do what you can do.
Yep.
Sorry.
Alright, well, we got one new subscriber, which is, Cooper.
Cooper.
Well, that's a follower, not even a subscriber.
Oh, yeah, that's a follower.
You're not partnered.
That's true. You know what? We will be. Eventually, someday, it's gonna happen.
I think we just gotta like throw it on Twitter to those like advertiser bots.
Yeah, we just gotta hashtag the shit out of it, and then like people will watch it. Actually, if we can, you know what the easiest scam would be, is if you can just convince people, even if they're not gonna watch it, like tell your friends just to turn on the stream to give us viewers and leave it on a browser in the background, because like there's like a threshold of like.
I hope we're not streaming this now.
Oh, we are. But we're scamming. Listen, I'm keeping it real here. We want to be the top. We're not afraid to admit it. All right. Well, anyways, like, comment, subscribe. Look for this video on YouTube. Minus the beginning part, which Dave said some questionable things, but we won't mention what they are. Because
We won't broadcast. Dave went off on one of his legendary rants about those.
No, none of that is true.
Don't worry, Dave. I'll cut it all out. It'll be in the After Dark series.
Oh boy.
We talk about all of our lewd.
You know what those are? Seahawks.
Yeah, Dave. Whoa. Yeah, Dave comes clean about how he loves the Seattle Seahawks.
Yeah.
And how he actually has like a shrine, like a voodoo pin cushion for Aaron Rodgers.
Pete Carroll, he said, was the best coach ever.
Yeah, Pete Carroll, definitely not a cheater.
All right, shutting off the stream.
I don't know why. I always thought it was Belichick, but he says Pete Carroll.